Thank you very much, Tuan. Again, my background is I started as an engineer in late 80s, early 90s, working in Melbourne, working for Cornell Wagner. I got some colleagues here, so at that time we worked together on some high rise. In fact, today I'm not going to spend too much time, but under high rise and so on, we have again interest in the fire safety side. And with the these things are basically almost common sense these days. And we are having communication systems, alarm systems, means of evacuation will come in the next presentation and so on. So I won't spend too much time on that. And there were some changes to high rise after the World Trade Center. Again, one of the best people to talk about this is the next Dr. Jonathan Barnett, who has been in the World Trade Center investigation team. I think I was the only one from Australia. I was in that team, but I communicated from here because the Gene Cawley, we remember Dr. Gene Cawley, he was basically leading the presentation, was very close to us, close to our group here, and has come so many times, used to visit us so many times. So basically, a lot of things we even discussed at that time, and unfortunately, he passed away a few years back. And I know Dr. Jonathan Barnett was a very important member of that investigation team. So basically, there were some changes, which it's in the notes we distributed as well. So I'm not going to read all that number of changes. And then very quickly running through that, those days there was only one lift. And again, Jonathan was telling us today that even Melbourne still they are doing this. So only one staircase. So basically, the firefighters had to use the same stairs. So there were some changes around the world. At least I'm involved in a few high rise at the moment. They have two stairs. So that has changed. And Burj Khalifa, we know that there's an evacuation elevator there, and that I think the World Trade Center collapse contributed to some changes in Burj Khalifa design as well. Occupant evacuation elevators have come in, and then the refuge flows. We can't just go down, and Kate will be talking later on the evacuation. I'll leave it that, but we need some special flows for refuge flows. So we are basically doing some work under the high rise, all that, some of these areas which are related to the fire performance and the Burj Khalifa. I was part of the team as well of Burj Khalifa in a peripheral way. So designing columns and all that. So I was part of these discussions. And then, in fact, this is interesting. These days when we design high rise, it's really like an aesthetic requirement. There are very good architects in the audience. We just put the sky bridge. I'm involved in about 3 or 4 high rise at the moment. Every building has a sky bridge. So it's really been put in. It's just that as an aesthetic or the feature, but it's really helping as a for evacuation as well. And at that time, Petronas, they didn't put the sky bridge in between for that purpose, but now it's really very useful. So again, I'll skip that. So pressurization of lifts and so on, because those days we couldn't use the lift during fire, but now we can use them because of the changes, especially after the World Trade Center. These things came, people knew about it, but came into practice a bit more. So I'll just leave it there and then hand over to Dr. Kate Nguyen, who is basically the our lead of the innovative fire engineering group, and also done a PhD in fact under myself and I suppose Duan Noh, working on the facade fire. And it was from a big linkage grant we got with the company Perma Stilisa, again led by Assistant Professor Duan Noh. We had about very good project with the facade company, but fire was one of the main projects. We will be talking about all that. So